In this video, we're looking at the Hughie Thomasson solo in the middle of Green Grass and High Tides. It's the part where the band is behind him on an E minor, G, and a C. It's still kind of the slower part of the song. So that's going on in the background. And the solo, you know, he takes, if you notice, there's a G in this chord, there's G in here, and there's G in here. So he plays around on that G a lot, and actually he holds out the G and the D, and then the open G and D string, and he gives that A a bend up to the B, and he'll do things like... So, and what you'll notice there a lot in between, he'll go back and forth on the open D and G string, like that. So, I'll play through it. He does, and as he gets up into the other part, he does that same type of thing when they're on C chord. You know, he'll play the two notes together a lot. That type of stuff. So, I'll play through the solo now. Solo comes in there. Okay, so that solo's all over the place. I found it pretty challenging to memorize all of that, but what I do is listen to it slowly as I'm finding each note and really get to know the melody in my head. And once you know the melody, it's like singing a song. You just kind of repeat it and speed it up. So I'll give you a slower look now. It's kind of hard to bend that G string up to the B because you're way down here by the nut on the guitar. But if you do it a while, you'll get your calluses on your finger and it becomes easier. Also, you want to have a lighter gauge string. I use the extra light 09 to 42 gauge. So, FYI. Again. That would be like the first phrase I would get to know, and then you repeat it, it becomes easier, and you get into the second phrase. And I'll just kind of go through the solo again now, the whole thing, more slowly. Thank you. Thomas looks cool at the end here. He does. So that one, what you do, you got to come across and come into the C like that. And then he does a little and keeps hitting the C chord. And then this one here, it's again, it's just a melody you got to remember. You know, notice here, he does that right away, but then that one he doesn't. But then he does the next two. So the whole thing goes. And there's that crossover again. And now he's on the top three strings of the E minor chord. There's that kind of crossover again. And then you're just into the rhythm. So, I've actually tabbed all that out. I know people like tabs, so I'll be selling the full lesson, and the tab will be included. So, I hope you enjoyed that.